right, fella. Let go of her.
Lark, hell.
You heard me. Let go of her.
So what's it got to do with you?
She doesn't want to go with you, creep. Get in the car. You sure know how to pick him, don't you?
Hey, come here. Come back. You bitches. I'll get you for this.
Oh, God. Bloody pigs.
Fantastic, isn't it? You get bashed and robbed. Bloody law doesn't care less. Look, where is that plainclothes guy? He said he was going to fix everything up. I suppose he's out the back pretending to look busy too, is he? Ah, stuff it. I'm not going to hang around here all day.
Well, Mr. Crosby.
Well, about bloody time. I'm losing money hanging around here. I've got clients to see.
Seem to be losing money wherever you are, aren't you? Now, do you want to hear what we found out about last night or not?
Yeah. What did he come up with?
I've just been talking to the taxi company, and they say the name of the driver is Judy Bryant.
Well, what about her mate?
Mate?
The girl that I picked up.
You're saying that she assaulted you too?
Well, what do you reckon? Is one Sheila going to knock me around like that?
I suppose not. However, this Bryant's a pretty tough customer. She's just on time at Wentworth. And according to our records, she was involved in an incident just a couple of days ago. A bloke finished up in hospital.
Hell.
Well, she'll probably deny the charges, so we'll need you to identify.
Oh, no, mate, no way. I've got a wife and kids to think about.
Look, do you want us to pick her up or not?
Yeah, of course I do. Just that I don't want a big fuss. Yeah, well, all right. You've got my number. Give us a ring when you've picked her up.
Real stout-hearted citizen, huh? Oh, come on. Grab your cap and we'll go and see what Brian's got to say about it.
Oh, bloody birds. Really very lucky. No permanent damage and no infection.
Oh, I didn't think there would be. Mr. Marney keeps that press as clean as a whistle. I reckon you could eat off it.
I don't think Mr. Marney could do anything wrong in your eyes, could he?
Been carrying on a bit, haven't I?
Yes, you could say that.
Sorry. Oh, but he was really great. Oh, when it first happened, I thought I'd had it. But he started joking about Peter Pan and Captain Cook and...
Hook.
What?
Hook. Peter Pan and Captain Hook.
Oh, yeah, of course. Well, I didn't get the joke at first, but it was just the way he said it. You had to laugh.
Perhaps I should talk to him. Could do with a bit of a laugh myself.
You tie a real good bandage. Is that why some of the women call you Doc?
Well, you can go back to your own cell. Sister Franklin wants you off work detail for a while.
And what am I supposed to do then?
Just take things easy until you recover, I suppose.
Oh, you mean just hang around? I've finished with Susie, Mrs. Morris. Her hand's doing very well.
Good. How's it feel, Susie?
No worries, Mrs. Morris. Can I go back to the workshop?
Finish up here, Peterson. You've got a visitor.
See ya.
Just wait outside for a few minutes, will you, Susie?
She's a nice kid.
Yes, let's hope she stays that way. Let's hope you haven't got any ideas about revenge.
Revenge? Don't know what you're talking about.
Now, come on, I've been here too long to buy that one. What happened to you wasn't a normal bashing. Someone was out to kill you, and you know it.
Kill me? Well, if I'd known that kind of thing was going to happen here, I wouldn't have come. No one said anything about that in the brochure.
Oh, Sandy, for heaven's sake. If you want to look for trouble, all hell will break loose. The women will take sides.
I fight my own battles.
Then somebody will get hurt, maybe even killed. Now, that could be someone who wasn't even involved. Someone like that nice kid out there, Susie Driscoll.
I fight my own battles. She'll be all right.
You can't guarantee that. Now, if there's anything I can do, you tell me.
Tell you what, Mrs. Morris. If the work becomes too hard for me, you've got the job, okay?
Now, just a minute. Everything I told you was perfectly true.
Not according to your friend, the policeman. He went to every location you gave him.
And?
Nothing. All he found were several irate, solid citizens.
Oh, but that's not possible. It came straight from Sandy Edwards herself. Well, damn him! The man's an idiot. I served it up to him on a plate. What am I supposed to do? Give him a street directory?
Yeah, well, he's not happy, I can tell you that much.
He's not happy. Well, that's his fault, not mine. He obviously went to the wrong places.
Grace, make a mistake. You've got to be joking. He wants Edwards so much his eyes water when you mention a name. He wouldn't blow an opportunity like that.
Unless... Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
She fed me the wrong information on purpose. To set me up.
Yeah, well, it's all getting out of hand as far as I'm concerned. You can count me out.
Oh, no, you're not going. You're not backing out on me now. If I have been set up, I'm in more danger than ever. They'll kill me.
All right. But if I were you, I'd put a smile on Grace's face. From the sound of things, you're going to need all the help you can get.
That's the taxi. You can bet she's cleaned it out by now. You have a look around outside while I have a chat to her. Senior Detective Burke, this is Constable Davis. I'd like to talk to you about your movements last night, if you don't mind.
You make it sound as though I've got a choice.
Oh, don't be like that. It's talk like that that gives us a bad name.
What do you want?
Well, firstly, I'll tell you what we know already. Now, it seems that you and an accomplice assaulted one of your passengers and stole his wallet. Now, you picked him up.
Just a minute, you've lost me.
You deny it.
I never stole a thing. I picked up a guy. He gave me a hard time. I had to throw him out of the taxi. Look, I'm on parole. You don't think I'm going to do anything to blow that? It's a wallet. So what?
So we found it in your garbage bin. Which means you've blown your parole, lady.
Morning, Judy. Who are your friends?
More to the point, who are you?
My name's Wally. Well, I'm the owner of this magnificent estate. What's going on?
You're not going to believe this. They said that I thumped some guy and took his money.
I suppose you got evidence or a witness?
Found a wallet in your garbage bin. Credit cards, but no money. Credit cards are made out in the name of Mr. Richard Cosby, who happens to be the name of the complainant.
Yeah, and he happens to be a creep, too.
Do you know him, Judy?
No, and I don't want to. Look, all that happened was that this guy and a kid got in my car. They said to take him to the Sunset Hotel, and then he started to make a nuisance of himself.
All right, Brian, give us the details down the station. Excuse us, sir.
Look, officer, or whatever you are, look, I've known Jude for ages. She is not violent.
I'm sorry, I've had a complaint. I've got enough to take her in. She lived with you for long?
Just a few days.
Well, if we need any more, I'll be in touch with you, Mr.
Wallace, Albert Wallace.
Yeah. Okay, Phil.
Mind if we join you?
If you like.
What's the matter? Something wrong with the food?
Isn't there always? You know, I've been trying to work out what made me sick the other night. What do you reckon, Doc? Do you reckon it might have been the food?
It's possible, I suppose. Now, I don't see why the rest of us weren't affected.
Mm. Yeah. I suppose if I had a suspicious mind, I might think someone was trying to have a go at me.
What? Put something in your food? Really, Sandra, you surprise me.
Yeah. I mean, where would they get the stuff? All that kind of thing's kept in the hospital.
Yeah.
Isn't it, Doc?
I can't get over this place. It's not even Sunday and they're giving us roast beef and veggies for lunch.
Beef? Are you sure that's beef?
Yeah, of course it is. It's a bit tough, but it's better than the stuff we got at the last place.
Here, give it to me.
Oh, yeah, some sort of plastic sausages and grey goo. And if you was real bad, they'd give you seconds.
Yeah, well, don't go telling Lizzie you like her cooking, otherwise she'll get a swollen head.
Oh, Lizzie cooked this?
Yeah, Lizzie or Mari, they both cop kitchen duty today.
Is that so? Mm. You know, it seems to me that everywhere I am, Mari isn't. I'd say the screws are trying to keep us apart.
And a bloody good thing, too. You and Winter keep fighting. You end up in the pound. You can't do anything from there.
Oh, where are you off to?
Got a bit of a headache. I thought I'd go and lie down for a while.
Oh, well, look, if you're feeling sick, why don't you go to the shower blocks and try and make yourself chuck? It did wonders for me.
Bitch. Hey, not in front of the KID.
Oh, very funny, Beck.
Yeah, I'm a scream. So, you like the workshop and you love the food. Does that mean you're staying with us?
Oh, no way. I'm off the first chance I get.
Mm. You know, I think that sounds like she doesn't like us.
Oh, no, I think you're all great. You and Bea, Kate and Lizzie.
Wrong. Kate is not great. Kate
is not to be trusted under any circumstances. Understand?
You say so, Beck.
I say so. Now, eat the veggies. Make your hair curl.
Quite frankly, Sergeant, I wish the department had allowed us to handle this ourselves. It's not the first time that the women have forged the staff signatures, and it will not be the last.
Yes, but this time they used official requisition forms, Mrs. Davidson, which means they obtained government property by fraudulent means, very definitely a police matter.
I suppose so. Is Smith the only one you want to see?
Yeah, for the moment. Though there is one other thing. Inspector Grace and I have reason to believe there's a plot going on to get drugs into the prison.
Oh, surely not.
Mm. So it would be of help to us if Smith could be kept isolated from the other women after I've spoken to him.
Come in.
Oh, excuse me, Mrs. Davidson. Judy Bryant's just been brought in. I thought you might like to speak to her.
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. I'll see her in a moment. I can assure you that B. Smith would have nothing to do with any plot involving drugs.
Very probably, but we would like her isolated.
Very well. But when you speak to her, please remember she had major surgery not so long ago. I can assure you she is violently opposed to drugs. I know you have a job to do, but I do not want her upset.
Don't worry, Mrs. Davidson. I'll be careful.
Come in, Mrs. Morris. Judy, I am very sorry to see you back in here.
Yeah? Well, I'm not too happy myself, although I'm not surprised.
Well, what do you mean by that?
Oh, come on, Mrs. Davidson. I don't stand a chance. None of us do.
No, that's not true, Judy. You had a good job and a good accommodation. That's a lot more than most people have.
Yeah? Well, I also have a record. And that means that any citizen can accuse me of anything they like, and chances are I'll end up back in here. I don't count. Oh, yeah, sure. I got a job, didn't I? My daughter practically had to beg for that. I had a flat, but she had to sign the rent in her name. I mean, what do they think I'm going to do? Have a one-woman orgy in that place at night?
It's very hard to fight prejudice, I know.
Well, it's not fair. It's just not fair.
You're off your head, kid. You keep breaking out of here and they'll keep on extending your sentence.
What a care. Gee, I'm only supposed to be a ward of the state, and they stick me in an adult prison.
And do you know why?
Because you keep on breaking out of the other places. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You're only making things worse for yourself.
Oh, yeah. Well, I reckon what you and Murray Winter's doing is pretty silly, too.
That's different. And besides, you keep out of it.
But you're my friend. I only want to help.
Oh, God. Do we have to get you out of here before you go rotten? I tell you what. You come up with a nice, safe way of breaking out of here, and I'll see what I can do to help. In the meantime, you can forget about helping me. Keep your ears open, certainly, but keep out of the way. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
That's what Mrs. Davidson said, so I'll tell you the same thing. There's been a fraud committed involving the illegal use of official government documents, namely departmental requisition forms.
And I thought this was all about somebody nicking stuff in the kitchen.
Not somebody. You.
Then why didn't you say so? Anyway, you're wrong. Stop using all the legal jargon, okay?
You're denying it.
Ah, now that I understand. Yes, I'm denying it. So what's wrong with you? You got odd socks on or something?
What?
You keep walking around behind me. I thought maybe you had something to hide.
Don't get smart with me, Smith. Oh, well, it doesn't matter anyway. You'll be officially charged tomorrow in front of the VJ. We've got more than enough evidence to add a couple of years to your sentence.
Oh, well, then, no point chatting anymore, is there? Nice meeting you.
How's the drug racket getting on with Peterson?
Come again?
The drug racket. How's it going?
Now, I don't know what you're fishing for, but you're using the wrong bait. Unless nobody's told you, B. Smith and drugs don't go together, and you had better forget it or I will forget I'm a lady.
Okay. What about Peterson, then?
Well, why would she? She's got her appeal coming up, and I believe she has a very reliable witness.
Oh, yes, very reliable. Pillar of society.
How come you know so much?
I'm the witness. So I wouldn't bet on Dr. Peterson getting out if I were you. It's called police cooperation. She's been giving us some information on a friend of yours in return for a witness. Mind you, she doesn't know I'm in the force.
And how come you're telling me all this?
Two reasons. First, I thought we might swap some information.
Forget it.
And second, I've arranged for you to go to isolation after you leave here. So you won't be able to do anything about it anyway.
Don't you bet on it.
Oh, how are you, B?
Oh, full of the joys of spring. What do you think? Hey. Where's the hard help?
Governor's orders. Officers to bring in your meals from now on.
Oh, geez, you could always hang a bell around my neck to keep the others away.
I'll be back later for the train.
Hey, Mrs. Morris, I heard about you losing the deputy governor's job.
I didn't lose it.
Oh, sorry, but let me finish. I learned a couple of things yesterday, a couple of very interesting things.
I'm listening.
How do you think Officer Powell got to the top so fast?
I know how, but I'd be interested in hearing your version.
Well, she's been playing super screw lately, right? Knows all about our capers before we even get up to them.
Someone's been lagging?
Kate Peterson. Has to be. She's the reason I'm in here and she's the reason you lost that job.
I didn't lose the job. I turned it down. But what makes you think she's been lagging?
The cop told me yesterday. Apparently she's been putting the finger on people in exchange for certain favours from Inspector Grace. Now, if she'd do that, she wouldn't bat an eyelid about lagging to Powell.
It's possible.
It's a dead cert. And something's got to be done before someone gets hurt.
What do you suggest?
Look, is there any chance of a visit from Sandy?
Oh, no, you know better than that.
It's the only way.
Look, if you spoke to Sandy, somebody would get hurt. I'm sorry, B. I appreciate you confiding in me, but it's out of the question.
Can I come in for a minute, Judy?
You already are.
Sorry, but I need to talk to someone.
Okay, shoot. This should be interesting.
Things have gone crazy since you left.
Yeah, I noticed a few changes about the place. What do you think caused it?
Well, it's Sandy, Judy. She's changed. I can't quite explain what's happening, but, well, whatever it is, it's dangerous. And I mean dangerous for us all. Her behavior's erratic and unstable, and, well, she just can't be trusted. God knows, I've tried to help her.
Well, perhaps it has something to do with a letter that she never received.
What?
And the fact that her husband was killed in Pentridge because she never received that letter. Or she might have been upset because she was forced to kill Fitzwater. And I don't think that Mari and her heavies trying to kill her would have helped either. You see, Kate, I talked to Sandy at breakfast. Now, I've never been to medical school, but I would think that those little things would have upset a person. What do you think, Doc?
What's going on here?
Nothing. Kate's just filling me in on what's been happening since I've been gone.
Aren't you supposed to be in the hospital, Peterson?
Yes, Mrs. Morris.
Judy, you've got a visitor.
Oh, Wally, it's good to see you.
It's nice to be appreciated, isn't it, Mrs. Morris?
Well, shouldn't you be at pottery class or something?
Oh, yeah, sure, but oh, what the heck? Somebody's got to look after you. Might as well be me. Hey, you don't go all sloppy on me, come on.
I'm sorry. You're some nice guy, you know that?
Not so bad yourself. I wish I could say the same for our passenger of the year, Mr. Ronald Crosby.
Did you talk to him?
I talked to him. He yelled at me. Blokes like that made me want to go to the country in the first place. Haven't felt like punching somebody for ages like that.
You see what I do to people?
Oh, it wasn't so bad. I tried to find that girl, but I didn't have any luck. Now, I got a few interesting suggestions from some other women.
All right, that does it. I don't want you doing any more, Wally.
I'm not finished yet.
Yeah, I just don't want you getting involved in this.
Look, I can't stand by and watch you go under without lifting a finger to help you.
I appreciate what you're trying to do, but please. I mean, if you keep poking around and all this, they're going to bring you in for questioning, you know?
No, I can't just do nothing.
All right. There's one thing you can do for me. Would you go to the post office and ask them to redirect my mail from the flat to the prison? I don't want Laurie to know about this.
There's not much to do.
It's enough. It's more than enough.
Honestly, Sandy, this is stupid.
What are you complaining about now?
Well, if I'm well enough to work in here, why can't I go and work with Lizzie in the workshop?
Oh, so it's Lizzie you're missing, is it? I thought it might have been your boyfriend.
Mr. Marnie's not my boyfriend.
How did you know who I was talking about then?
It's not like that, honestly. He's just nice, that's all. There wasn't anyone like him in Juve Home.
Okay, I'm sorry. I was just having you on.
Oh, Juve, where have you been?
Well, not that it's any of your business. I had a visitor. Is that all right with you?
Okay. There's no need to snap my head off.
Sandy?
That's me.
I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. What's up? Someone been giving you a bad time?
Hardly that. It's Wally. He just came to see me. He's such a nice guy. I don't want him involved in this.
Is he your boyfriend?
I think you better fill the kid in, eh?
Just thought I'd say it before Sandy did.
Oh, look, I said I was sorry. Would you get off my back?
Now, would you stop working, please, ladies? Mrs. Davidson would like to speak to you.
I know you must be wondering about B. Smith, so I have decided to tell you what is happening before the rumors start distorting things.
Is she all right?
Yes, she's perfectly well. But until the police have finished their inquiries, she will be kept apart from the other inmates.
You mean she's in the pound?
No, she's in isolation. And anyone found trying to communicate with her in any way will be held as an additional suspect.
Well, that's good old British justice for you, isn't it?
That's enough, Bryant.
Of course, the sooner this matter is cleared up, the sooner she will be back with you. So if any of you can help the police with their inquiries, I shall be glad...
Just a minute! The reason that we are in this place in the first place is because of police. It's them or us, remember? Are you asking us to help them?
You only have yourselves to blame.
That's bull! I
I'm in here because of the system and its rotten laws. I don't stand a chance, do I? So don't you tell me that I've got myself to blame.
You are upset, Bryant. So I shall overlook your outburst. But don't you ever raise your voice to me again. Mrs. Morris, I think Bryant could do with some fresh air. Take her out into the garden.
Come along, Judy.
I find you guilty on both charges, Smith. Before I pass sentence, is there anything you'd like to say?
Tons, but I expect you're late for the country club and I'd hate to keep you.
That's enough, Smith.
Mrs. Davidson? Sergeant Ross?
There is one thing, sir. As I mentioned to the governor, pending certain inquiries we're making into another case, we would like to request that the prisoner be kept isolated from the other women.
I'm sure that can be arranged, Mrs. Davidson.
Certainly.
Beatrice Smith, I find the evidence against you to be conclusive and satisfactory. I therefore sentence you to an additional 6 months' imprisonment.
You're keeping yourself pretty busy.
You bet. Hey, Sandy. Oh, you know that fat lady. What's her name? Is it Judy?
Hmm.
She's a bit of a grump, isn't she?
Well, as a matter of fact, she's a really nice person. But you heard what she said at breakfast. Wouldn't you be upset? She's like you. She shouldn't be in here.
Well, why doesn't she do what I'm doing?
Oh, yeah. What the hell are you doing?
Making a dress for when I break out.
Out of that grotty old sheet.
Well, I saw a dress just like it in one of those magazines, and they wanted $50 for it.
Oh, I bet they did. But you better be careful. You don't want everyone cottoning on to what you're doing, do you? Not that anyone around here would lag on you, right, girls? Be careful just the same. Need any help?
No, thanks. I'll be right. It's a bit of a nuisance with this bloody hand.
Don't swear.
No, Mum.
And don't be a smart-ass either.
Just a minute, Peterson.
Sister Franklin gave me permission to get ready for lunch, Mrs.
Morris. Yes, well, I'm not worried about that. Look, I'm not going to beat around the bush. I've just heard a very serious rumour from one of the prisoners, and I want a straight answer from you.
Well, of course, I'll do what I can to help. That's the trouble in here, you know. There's not enough cooperation.
Forget it, Peterson. I am not Mrs. Powell. Now, you've been accused of two things. Informing to the police and lagging to prison officers. Now, is this true or false?
That's ridiculous. On earth did you hear that?
It's not important. What is important is that you tell me the truth.
But I am Mrs. Morris. It's absolutely absurd.
I hope so.
Look, I don't understand. I thought prisoners were encouraged to help the staff.
There is a huge difference between helping and telling tales, Peterson. Now, you've seen how violent these women can get. So there's no need for me to tell you what they would do to an informer. If someone gets caught lagging, they get hurt. And hurt very badly. Now, for your own sake, if you've got something to say, say it to me now. Very well. I can't force you. Get ready for lunch.
What's the matter with her?
Oh, I'll tell you at lunch. Come on.
All right, Fisher, back to your duties. Here you go, Smith.
Thanks. Mr. Faulkner, look, I've got to see Sandy. I know it's against the regulations, but couldn't you swing it for me, please? It's important.
You'd be joking. The governor put you in here to keep you away from the others.
I'm not joking, damn it! I'm sorry, I didn't mean that.
What's wrong?
Look, could you get a message to her for me?
Oh, come on, Smith, you know I can't do that.
Sandy's a nice kid and she's going to be in big trouble if someone doesn't... Just tell her she was right.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, don't ask me. I can't tell you.
Look, if you tell me what trouble she's in, I can get the rest of the officers to keep an eye on her.
And where were the rest of the officers when she was nearly killed in the shower block? No. Sandy's the only one who can do anything. Just tell her not to trust her friend.
I'll think about it.
Thanks. Hey, Mr. Faulkner. Thanks for the clean clobber.
That's right.
Oh, hey, is there any chance of getting my dressing gown washed? It's getting a bit, whiffy.
Yeah, I'll come back and get a lab.
Thanks.
B. Smith told you all that with no strings attached?
No, not quite. She wanted a visit from Sandy Edward.
I thought so. Get nothing for nothing from that one.
I'm worried, Janet. It's been a long time since we had a police informer in here. It wasn't very pleasant, I can tell you.
Afternoon, ladies.
Oh, Mr. Marnie, why don't you join us?
Didn't know you were coming apart.
I see you still don't trust the food here.
Yeah, no way. The women called yesterday's lunch at Regan's Revenge. I can take a hint.
How are you getting on with the women?
Well, I'm not sure, but I think they have decided to keep me on. I hope so, anyway. Some of them are showing real promise, especially Aunt Susie Driscoll.
Yes, I heard she was one of your star pupils.
Certainly was. Into everything until that cut hand slowed her down a bit.
Yeah, I think you might have won her heart there.
That's wrong, you know. A kid like that shouldn't be in a place like this. I mean, she is an intelligent little thing, but when she's got to mix with people like... Well, no names, but you know what I mean, don't you?
Yeah, you're dead right. She's the only decent thing in here.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. Old Lizzie's pretty harmless, I reckon.
Harmless? Lizzie could teach Susie more ways of beating the system than you ever dreamed of.
You're kidding.
Well, let's look at it this way. If you shook hands with Lizzie, count your fingers afterwards.
I did.
God, I've forgotten my knife and fork.
Oh, it's all right, Lizzie. I'll get them for you.
Thank you, love, and some bread and butter if you wouldn't mind. Beautiful little kid, isn't she? You wouldn't catch many of them her age chasing around after an old chook like me, would you?
Well, don't get used to it. The way she talks, she'll be going over the top any minute.
Hey, Al, would you have a look at this? Well, look. There you go, Lizzie. Save some for later.
Real proud of you, love. I couldn't have done better myself.
Oh, what? It was nothing. Had to do that all the time at the last place it was at.
Yeah, well, you're not there now, Driscoll. So don't start pulling any of your smart little delinquent tricks in here. Bag her off, Mari, and leave her alone. Shut up and hit your din-dins, Granny, or I'll take it off you.
Why don't you have mine? Okay, Mari, call your heavies off.
Righto, get lost.
Don't you ever speak to Lizzie like that again.
What's going on, Winter?
Nothing, Mr. Faulkner. Just a little accident, right, Murray?
Yeah, right.
Well, clean it up. Edwards, outside. I've got a message for you.
Who from?
Can't say. The message simply reads, don't trust your friends and you were right. Does it mean anything to you?
Yeah. Oh, I've got a fair idea.
And that's what I did. I still can't believe that I did it, but I did. I walked straight out the gate as though I was a visitor.
I've got my dress made and everything.
God, you're a wag. Oh, but it's too hard to set up, love. You've got to have a visitor's pass, and God, they're not easy to come by.
I'll get one. You'll see.
Why don't you do what Jude did? Of course, you have to pretend you're real sick. Then you have to get them to send you on the outside to the general hospital. It's dead easy to get out of the hospital.
Do you reckon Judy would tell me how she did it?
Well, I suppose so, love. But I wish you wouldn't. You'd be wrecking a young life. I mean, it's all right for old bags like me. What do you want?
I reckon your little friend here needs to be taught a lesson.
You leave her alone, you bitch.
Shut up, Birdsworth.
Go on. Bug her off.
Maybe you'd like a little tap on the head, too.
You heard what Lizzie said. Leave us alone.
Well, just wise up, you two. I've got better things to do with me time than go around teaching little babies and stupid old bags how to behave.
Hell. Don't swear.
G'day. Like a cup of coffee?
No, thanks, mate.
Oh, what's the matter with you? Personal problems or work?
You any good at giving advice?
No, not very. But you can try me if you like.
If one of the prisoners confides in me about something that might cause trouble in the prison, should I go to Mrs. Davidson about it?
Well, it depends. What sort of trouble?
Well, that's just it. I don't know. I'm not even sure what the prisoner was talking about.
Well, of course, if it's serious, you must go to Mrs. Davidson. If not,
Well, I think it often pays to keep the women on side. So it depends on your own judgment.
Great. None the wiser. This damn job is more than just a pay packet, isn't it?
Call her Houdini.
Yeah. She couldn't have done it right.
Hey, who are you, love? The expert. This is a real prison, you know. Not like those other times.
I know it'll be a bit harder, but I reckon I'll do it. Oh, sorry.
It's just a matter of keeping my eyes open and looking for things I can use.
What sort of things?
Well, you know. Well, things to disguise myself.
What do you mean? Wearing a beard.
There. You see what I mean? There's always something laying around.
You sneaky little bugger.
Where's a good place to bury them?
Ready for a bite, Smith?
Yeah, but do you mind if I finish my meal first?
Back to your old self, I see.
Yeah, well, it's been cooped up in here with nothing to do. Hey, did you speak to that certain party?
Yes.
Thanks, it's one I owe you.
You've got some laundry for me, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. And make sure I get the same one back, will you? Otherwise, I'll sue. Oh, tell that lot out there to cut out the laughter, will you? Don't they know this is a prison? It's just disgusting.
Nothing on this lady.
All right, Birdsworth, you've had your fun. Where are my glasses?
I'm not Birdsworth, Mrs. Barry. No, I'm over here.
Answer me, Birdsworth, or I'll put you on report.
What's going on, Mrs. Barry?
Oh, Mr. Faulkner, thank heaven. One of these women has stolen my glasses.
All right, who's got them? Right, you'll all be searched in reception. Move. You don't find them, it looks like you'll be going home early.
Oh, that should be fun. I can't even see the steering wheel without my glasses. You gave me a fright.
Yeah, you look a bit jumpy. Maybe you should get a nerve tonic. Shouldn't be hard for you to get something from the hospital, should it? Didn't see you at the exercise period. You missed a lot of fun.
Thought it best if I stayed away from the women. Seems someone's spreading rumours about me.
Oh, God, people are funny buggers, aren't they? You know, someone was actually trying to tell me that one of my friends was a lagger. I mean, how thick do they think I am? One of my friends a lagger? Oh, God, they'd have to be pretty stupid. Unless they really wanted to make me angry. What do you reckon, Doc? Do you reckon anyone would be that stupid?
Just in time to save you. Now, wasn't that lucky?
Save me?
Well, you know what they say about people who drink by themselves.
Oh, I see what you mean. Actually, I'm meeting Meg down here for a drink.
Uh-huh. Yeah, of course. Yes, I understand perfectly. What would you like to drink while you're waiting?
I'll have a brown cow, thank you.
We'll eat later. What about a drink?
That is a drink.
Come on, Edwards. I should have left here an hour ago, so this will be rather rushed, I'm afraid.
Do you need me, sister?
Oh, no, thanks, Mr. Faulkner. Peterson will help.
I'll leave it to you, then.
Hey, send me a get-well card. Right, undo your buttons and onto the bed. Where have I heard that before? Ow. Well, that's looking better. How's it feel?
Still sore. Not much, but enough to give me a headache all the time.
Well, that makes sense, I suppose. Related, do you think, Peterson?
I'd say so, yes.
Well, we can just give you a painkiller for now. That's about all we can do for you today.
Bet I'd get better treatment if I was in a health fund.
Pulse is okay. You stay there and I'll get you that painkiller.
Uh-huh. I'll really be glad to get away from her today. She's very good, but can be a little pushy at times. Anyway, I'm glad you're feeling better.
I bet you are. I don't suppose many doctors get to follow a case through like you followed this one. I mean, you've been with it from the very start, haven't you? The very start.
I better see if sister needs me.
Don't tell me. You called Megan. She said she can't make it tonight, but she will meet you here tomorrow night, right?
Wrong. Joyce Barry's had an accident. Something about losing her glasses, so Meg has to stand in for it.
Brilliant. Mrs. Barry's glasses. It's a very ingenious story.
Well, it's true.
Of course. Okay, how about another Brown Bull? Dinner at the bistro, and then we'll go to the Gilmore Theatre and see the Kay Francis movie.
Who's Kay Francis?
Forgive her. Kay Francis was only one of the biggest box office names of the 30s and 40s. One Way Passage, A Virtuous Sin, The White Angel.
Look, I hate to disappoint you, but I don't really like old movies, so why don't we just forget it?
Well, how about dinner then?
Sorry, not tonight.
A brown cow?
All right, I'll have one more drink and then I've really got to go home.
Okay, I don't think you heard the last of this movie business. Us movie buffs do not give in easily.
We'll see.
The sooner the department employs a full-time doctor, the better off we'll all be.
Pardon? Oh, yes, I agree. It isn't fair asking you or Sister Johnson to do all this on your own.
It's impossible. I'm going to have to ask you your opinion now, because the doctor's left no instructions at all on a file. Do you think an ordinary paracetamol-based mixture could hurt her?
No, not at all. It's what I give her.
Blast! Sister Franklin? Yes, Miss Sharp. No, I'm afraid I can't. I'm supposed to have left here an hour ago. Well, when did it happen? Any swelling? Oh, why didn't you say that in the first place? All right, I'll be there in a minute. I give up. A sprained ankle in D block. Oh, I'll never get home. Take that into Edwards for me, would you?
But I can't. I'm not allowed...
Make you feel better. Looks like you could deal with it yourself.
Oh?
That's a bad case of the shakes you've got there.
Oh, what?
The shakes.
Well, as I said before, Sister Franklin isn't the easiest person to get along with.
No, I couldn't. You have it. You could deal with it.
Oh, don't be silly. Sister Franklin might come in.
Well, she can get her own. Drink it.
But it's for headaches, not nerves.
Drink it.
Christmas too, when morning comes around.